Yassas everyone, it's Latsborum and welcome to my latest boop video. We're playing now again Need for Speed Underground 2. It is the fifth part, and as you remember from the last episode, I had a really big problem with crashes. Hopefully this time it won't occur. And I also got a new car, and as you can see, it is this Lincoln Navigator. But we're going to change it with the Ford Focus because we need to drive further on. So what we're going to do is going back to the Explore mode. So what we're going to do now is to have a look what kind of races we might do. And I think let's go to the special event, but there where the sprint is. So I set the GPS to there and let's go. Now I actually managed to play this game with the Xbox One controller. The only thing which doesn't work are the triggers, so I have to use regular buttons in order to drive the car, because back then when the game was invented, there were actually no triggers, so the game relied all on buttons. Let's do the sprint. Okay, I have absolutely no idea with whom we race, but it doesn't matter, just that we win this race. The only thing what I hate about playing with the controller now is that my NOS is right above the throttle. So, as you know, the controller, it is, well, I accelerate with A, I brake with X, with B I've got the handbrake, and with Y I've got the nitrous. And the problem is I have to use my index finger in order to touch it. I cannot release the throttle if I'm driving, so, or I press the handbrake as you've seen now, so that's why I need to use the index finger. But nevertheless, I still manage to be first. And also what's annoying, yeah, I'm used to use the left trigger for braking, and unfortunately it doesn't work. It's a shame though, but I mean, still the game looks great and I have no problem with it. I hope I will get used to it. Just with the lead in this race. Unfortunately, it was a long time ago since I did the last recording, and I mean, it's quite difficult to find time to make a session where I can record multiple episodes, and this time I found eventually time to do so. 200 reputation points and 350 bank. I can select a sponsor. Okay, we've got this one from Bride, and I have to do 5 URL races, 3 sponsor races, and 19 races of my choice, 2 DVD covers, and I can get a new vehicle. Signing bonus 1775, each URL victory 1400, and 1150 per sponsor, 1 cursed, 1 sprint, and 1 drag. Then we've got Pia. 1 street cross, 1 cursed, 1 sprint. Like, I get 100 more for signing and 25 less for a sponsor race. And here I've got Alpine. 5 URL, yeah, the same. And 1100 and 3 street cross and 1950 for signing. So What I'm going to do now is I just pick a brand of choice, so let's go for Alpine. I love audio stuff. Go back to the Explorer mode and save the game. Okay, so the thing is, I forgot about what I talked before, but it doesn't matter. Now we got more progress and now we need to make money, and let's go and do the drag race. Hopefully that will be good with the controller. A Hyundai Coupe. Wow. Okay, I've got quite a big lead. And lol, I crashed into the crate. The other ones were a Golf and an MX-5. So, 200 and 350. Easy. Bacal. Streetcar magazine cover opportunity.
Streetcar magazine's reps are scoping around, so look sharp.
Nice. I suggest we go and do this special event now, because first of all, do the stuff what is the closest.
You better get an agent, bro, because it looks like a star is in the making.
Oh, cool.
You made the cut into the DVD.
Four on the floor. Okay, I just press too fast, but we can have a look later on the on this DVD cover if we go to the garage. And 736. So wow, that went actually fast. And we unlocked also a new quarter, the Jackson Heights. And I suggest we go and do the street cross up there. Or no. We go and enter the sprint. No, the drift, sorry. So, activate the GPS and let's go. Other things what I've planned to do in this or in the next episode is to customize the Lincoln Navigator and do some SUV races and to see how that one works out with the SUVs, because I don't remember how it is to drive an SUV. I just know that they are really, really bulky, that they are heavy, and that their steering is not so good, and that they have special races where mostly no traffic is going on, just the opponents, and that's it. And we'll see. Just that I earn a little bit more money, because I want to customize the SUV also with a turbo and some other performance upgrades, because they are so slow, because they're so heavy, unlike the nimble compact cars. Oh, come on, are you serious? Let's use some NOS. Okay, as I can see here, here was the graphics and the body shop, but we're going to have a look at them later. Now we're just going to do some races, and then we go from the top down, and then we can have a look what kind of upgrades we can do for the focus as well, in order to get more style. I also got organic drift racing. Plan each drift on organic tracks to take into account the direction of traffic. Drifting on the outside lane is risky because of the likelihood of oncoming traffic. Okay, good to know. Unlike the city center or Beacon Hill, this is a very mountainous area, hence the name Jackson Heights. And I believe the drift race is going to be a downhill drift, because that exists too, not just the arena or car park drift. And I believe if you do a downhill drift, that there will be no opponents, like they already have some scores. And when you do them, then you can have the whole race for on your own, just that you have some traffic going on. Here's a drift. Okay, that's an arena drift. Let's get in. A Supra 106 and Corolla. Interesting choice. Yeah, that's great. I still find it very amusing when you have a front-wheel drive car which drifts a lot better than a rear-wheel drive car. But there is an even bigger surprise. The best car for drift actually is an all-wheel drive car. Like, you can even drift with an SUV, but there are also some cars which are all-wheel drive. But I'm not going to tell too much about it, because we will unlock some more cars, and I lost over 24,000 points. What a shame. But we can get easily the points back. Yeah, 15,000 at one go. The focus became so much better after all these performance upgrades, and it's easier to drift with the controller than with the keyboard, that's for sure. 31,000, amazing. And no, I'm not playing this game on easy mode, I'm playing it on medium. Yeah, we're having now over the double of the points than the second place, so that's for sure 300 reputation points. Yeah, GG. 300 and 350, just like I said. New lights, carbon mirrors, spoilers and roof scoops, cool. That will suit definitely perfectly for a black car, but since the car is blue, I don't put any carbon fiber stuff on it, it just looks dreadful. I would like to know your opinion, so go and vote in the poll right in the top right corner. I would be interested what your opinion is like, if you like carbon fiber parts or just the regular painted ones. So yeah, let's do the street cross. That equals more money. Oh my god, my English. It just sucks when you want to drive all the way up to the heights and it takes too much time. So we are here to sponsor Street Cross 1100. It looks really weird, but it should not be a big problem.
I mean, the Focus can do everything from being the worst starter car in the game and the worst game overall. The worst car, sorry. Not the game. The game is perfect. No, RX-8, go away. I need to overtake the Peugeot and the TT. It's just difficult if you want to take corners and they have an angle wider than 90 degrees. Like this, but luckily the TT gave me some push and it was easier for me to get around. But I don't know if I will win because the... Okay, no, I restart the race. There is no point in order to race it until the end. Okay, easy game for me. They crashed. I hope I'm not going to be overtaken by all these people behind me, because one mistake equals you lose the race, unless you have an OP car and can easily overtake the others. Or you win this race when somebody else makes a mistake, so that's also a way how to win a race. I wish I could use NOS here, unfortunately this is not possible. But the turbo helps me a lot, that's for sure. I mean, just having a lead of over 5 seconds, this is insane, like... In other street cross races, you would actually end up with only 2 or 1.5 seconds, sometimes even just less than 1 second. But here, it works not good. It works not completely fine. Yeah, that's nice. I'm wondering how this one would actually look like if you really sit behind the steering wheel, probably really difficult and with pulling the handbrake all the time just to get around the corners. And also another important thing is concentration. Because you can easily get distracted and you hardly have somewhere a straight where you can actually just drive and hitting here the wall because of the time. Oh man, you see, not being concentrated leads crashing into a wall and then probably losing the game. But I won with just under 3 minutes. Why did I get only 200? I deserved 300 because my lead was so big. Whatever. 200 is good enough too. What did I unlock now? Hoods. New hoods. Cool. Let's see what we've got here. Trail braking. Oh, a drag race. Yeah, that's great. a hidden drag race that equals more money in a very short time. Okay, I was distracted by the other opponent. That was not good. Let's repeat it. We can make it. Come on. I need to repeat because it's so weird with the controls. Wow, almost, oh, 250? Yes. Wow, I won. Perfect. And I've beaten the Skyline and the Supra. With a Focus. Damn. No reputation points, but it's all about the money. A new ECU. Yes. I have the feeling that now, after every race, that I'm unlocking some new parts, which is of course a really good thing, but I think now we can invest some money into the cars, and the Focus definitely needs also a new ECU, especially now in this drag it was really really tight. First of all, see how the cursed here is. I hope it's not a long one. Come on, we can do that one. Yes. I know I used all the NOS in the beginning, but doesn't matter. I just want to take the lead, and it's easier when you do it right from the start. Now we're going to explore a little bit of the rest of the heights by this cursed, so have a look. It's actually really awesome to drive here because of all these corners where you can also pull the handbrake and do some uphill drifts. But if you want to do an outrun here, I definitely don't suggest this to you, because if you do this, the outrun will take ages, unless you flip the opponent over when he comes to a moment where he cannot overtake you. And that's also a problem too when you drive uphill, you cannot see incoming traffic. Oh man. It looks like as if they cannot drive either. But it should not be a big deal overtaking them. Ha ha ha. Oh my god. That was hilarious. Just crashing into the Peugeot and the Peugeot was basically flying. And this race is basically taking ages, I suggest. I believe it goes around 2.5 minutes. And taking... No! Oh my god. Thanks for the push, bro. Wow, it goes even more than 2.5 minutes. 2:42. Oh man. Imagine we have to restart this race. This will be just stupid. Yeah, I just hope that I won't make any further accidents. But as you can see, it's really difficult not to drive like a maniac. I don't know, but this section is so hard. Of course everyone is overtaking me. But just that in... But only because an Infiniti overtakes me, it doesn't mean that I can't overtake an Infiniti. You will see it in a few seconds. Or you will see this. Shit. Oh man. I probably won't win this race. I need a lot of luck. Nope, that race is going to be lost. Nope, the Infiniti is too far. I cannot overtake it. What a shame. Oh man. You finished second! Wasted over 5 minutes of my life. Okay, what we're going to do now is go to the body shop because I want to do some further upgrades. But we need to go there where the street crosses, so right and then left. Should be easy. And then I can finish this episode. Maybe I won't do any upgrades, but because I got some new stuff, and when I discover a new shop, I will get even more new stuff, so that will be actually a good idea to do so. So let's go down. I'm wondering what I will get here, because I don't remember what I got when I played this game for the last time. But I believe it will be maybe some new exhaust. That would be actually a really cool addition. And maybe I can get even some new stickers and vinyls for my Focus. That will be also really cool. A new front, rear, and side front and rear bumpers and side skirts. Cool. Let's have a look.
Yo, unless you want your ride to look like your mom's, then this is the place for you. All your visual upgrades are here. Fenders, spoilers, side skirts, and more.
So, we've got this one, the Ace, and then when we... Then we've got here Renegade, Shadow, Strike, Overdrive, and Sweeper. And from the back it's the same. I actually really like Strike. And then we've got... No, I don't want to put a new spoiler. And I don't need a new hood because this hood we which we have, it's actually a really good one. And the ones more, which we've got here more, are not worth it. Roof scoops. No, but lights. I know, I believe it was not these kind of lights, but lights at the exterior shop. Like, now I can show you how it would look like with a roof scoop out of carbon fiber. That's not my style. Maximum mirrors, but they are definitely not worth it. So let's leave the shop and see what we've got in the...
There's a camera crew here shooting for the next Four on the Floor sequel. Just make sure you cross the finish line first. You're in for sure.
Let's look what we've got here at the graphics shop. Access to additional paint categories, decal placements, and new vinyls. So.
Now credit is built with winning. This is the wet bar for your ride. Give it some distinction by coating it with some paint.
Like, we've got now metallic, and we have yet to unlock pearlescent sand. And we've got a gloss paint, and I would like to get a metallic paint job in dark blue. Yeah, that one looks pretty neat, so let's go for that one. Yeah, rims got powder coating. And for the brakes, we always need them red because Brembo's. And the muffler tip we can actually make in black. Looks really cool. And because we've got a new sponsor, I want to see if we can get Alpine stickers. Yes, we can get them, one for the front and one for the back. Purchase a setup and go back to explore more. So that's now the way how the car looks like from the back, and this is from the front. I'm going back to the garage because I need to save this game one more time. That was it. Sorry. So that was it from my side. I hope you really enjoyed the video. If you loved it, leave me a like, that would be really cool from you. Leave me also a comment for some feedback. Don't forget to vote for the poll. And also leave me a sub if you don't want to miss any of my future editions of this series or any of any other of my videos. So stay tuned and see you the next time. Bye bye.